gently and warmly on the cold foam of the ocean. But the little mermaid did not feel the touch of death. She saw the bright song, and above her hundreds of transparent, beautiful beings hovered through them. She could still glimpse the white sails of the ship and the red clouds of the sky. Their voices were melodic, but so that no human ear could hear them, just as no earthly eye could see them. Without wings, they floated effortlessly through the air. The little mermaid realized she had a body like theirs, rising higher and higher from the sea foam.
"Where am I going?" she asked, and her voice was like the others, so airy that no earthly music could ever capture its sound.
"To the daughters of the air," they answered, "mermaids do not have immortal souls. They can never have one unless they win the love of a human being. Only then can they share in eternal life." The daughters of the air also have no eternal soul, but through good deeds we can earn one ourselves. We fly to the warm lands where the stifling, pestilent air kills people. There we bring cooling breezes. We spread the scent of flowers through the air and offer comfort and healing. When we have strived for 300 years, doing all the good we can, we are granted an immortal soul and sharing the eternal happiness of humans."